What's up, nerds? It's me again, Anthony D. Mays, and if this is my last video, it's because the Terminator finally got me, y'all. Now, y'all know that when I talk about preparing for coding interviews and doing LeetCode problems, I tell you not to practice by yourself. But still, there are times when you gotta work alone. What are you gonna do? Imagine being able to use AI to mimic a FAANG interviewer, or to have someone who can be a brainstorm partner with you, or maybe someone who can help you think of good questions to ask in the interview. Today, we're going to talk about ways that we can use AI for our coding interview preparation. Now, listen, I'm as data-driven as the next guy, and according to the data that I'm seeing, you haven't subscribed yet. Come on, fam, what's going on? Hit that subscribe button. Make sure to like this video if you enjoy this content, because I want to keep making it for you and making it useful. And don't forget to leave a comment too. I love to holler back at folks. Now, here's something I've said for a long time. AI isn't going to take your job. It's people who know AI that are going to take your job. So the question is, how can we use AI as a tool to help us in our interview prep so that it's not doing too much of the work for us? Because ultimately, you're not going to be able to take tools like ChatGPT or Gemini or Claude or Grok into the interview with you. I mean, yeah, you can, but you definitely shouldn't. If you need to figure that out, go look at the other video that I did where I talked about this exact thing. So how do we use AI without cheating? How do we use these tools and make sure that we're still using actual intelligence and not just artificial intelligence to make things happen? So the first way that we can use AI to help us in our coding interview prep is to use it to help us practice stating a problem in our own words. What do I mean by that? As part of the problem solving process that I teach my candidates and clients, I often teach them to practice saying the problem in their own words. Usually in an interview situation, your interviewer is going to tell you the kind of problem that they want you to solve and write code for. And you should repeat the question back in order to give you time to think, in order to iron out communication issues, and because it gives your interviewer the chance to check whether your understanding of the problem is right or whether you have missed details or added details that weren't in the original problem statement. Even if you don't have a person that you can practice with, using AI tools can be a great way to have a sounding board that you can use for honing your problem-solving skills. It's about having this ability to interact with something that helps you to understand how you're working as a collaborative problem solver, even if a human being isn't in the room. So here's how I would do it. I would read a problem statement or listen to it auditorily, and then without looking at it, I would write the problem statement in my own words. Then I'm going to take the original problem statement along with the way that I wrote it and stick them both in the ChatGPT and ask it to compare if the two versions are similar or if I've missed something in the way that I stated it that was in the original problem. This can be great for making sure that I'm not missing details or that I'm not adding things that weren't there in the original problem statement. It helps to make sure that I am accurate in the way that I'm describing things. And it also helps me to be more comfortable with expressing the ideas in my own words, which is a very, very important part of demonstrating understanding. Here's the second way that you can use AI to help you in your coding interview prep. I enjoy using AI to help me come up with new questions that maybe I should ask for a particular problem. In the problem solving process, you need to know how to identify good questions to ask that will help you get information about the problem that you're trying to solve. If you aren't good at asking good questions, you can use AI to prompt for additional questions and compare the list of questions that it recommends to maybe the list that you come up with. So just like before, you should be writing out your own questions that you would ask in the interview situation, given some prompts. And then what you can do is ask AI to come up with a similar list of questions and see, did it suggest questions that maybe you didn't come up with? Did you come up with questions that maybe the AI didn't feel like it was important to address? Coming up with good questions isn't always an easy skill. Being inquisitive is something that you need to develop over time. And using AI can help you maybe think about questions that you hadn't thought about before that you can then incorporate into additional interviews as you're tackling different areas. Let me highlight you real quick. I've said countless times that I don't want you grinding LeetCode to memorize problems. You should learn the patterns. So a number of you have asked about where you can learn these patterns that help you tackle coding interviews more easily. And usually I just tell people to go to LeetCode or Google it. But recently the team at Educative reached out to me and offered a free trial of their platform. And let me tell you, I'm impressed. I just tried their course called Grokking the Coding Interview Patterns in my favorite language of JavaScript. You can choose your favorite language. And I was happy to discover that it's actually pretty thorough, covering everything from sliding window to heaps to tries and other kinds of patterns that you should know. What I like most of all is how the lessons remind me to use good problem solving strategies by incorporating exercises that help me to more easily recognize when certain patterns may apply when, say, I'm doing the brainstorming step. Now, they're not sponsoring this video, but I will drop my referral link down below where you can get 10% off a subscription. That should help you out, but will also go a long way towards supporting this channel. All right, hey, I hope that helps. Now back to the video. All right, here's the third thing that you can do with AI tools for coding prep. You can use AI tools to help you practice brainstorming multiple solutions for a problem. If you're the kind of person who, when you get into a coding interview, you can only ever just come up with a naive or brute force solution, you can use AI to give you hints that might point you in the direction of another solution so that it's not doing all of the work. One of the really useful things about LLMs is that you can use it as a very intelligent rubber duck. And you have to be careful because LLMs might just straight up lie to you, but still, maybe it can give you new questions to ask or help you to reflect on certain parts of the problem statement or things that you've learned to make that bridge into a solution that could possibly work for the problem. You can also maybe interrogate an LLM and ask it why a solution might not work, why it might not be useful, or ask it why a particular data structure might not be effective for the problem that you're trying to solve. By going through this interrogation, it's helping you to think critically about what you can and can't do for a problem, or to critically think about what tools you can still leave on the table or what tools won't be effective and the reasons why. You're keeping the focus on how you're collaborating with someone else. And even though the other person in the interaction is not a person at all, but rather a computer or an LLM, it still helps you to keep in mind the fact that you eventually are gonna have to be talking to another human being and going through this interaction of asking questions, clarifying assumptions, and following hints and responding to feedback well. Number four is a big one for me. For those of us who aren't really good at big O analysis yet, I think using an LLM or AI tools to help you think through big O and explain why something has a certain big O time or space complexity can be really, really clutch. Definitely use LLMs to help you understand different values of big O and how they work and how you would recognize that in the code. Getting explanations like that can help you to better understand why a solution would be a certain performance characteristic, even without writing the code. Getting better at that takes some time. Certainly you have to study Big O, and I always recommend bigocheatsheet.com as a way to help learn more about Big O and data structures and how those two things interrelate. If you need to understand whether your Big O analysis is correct or not, you can definitely use an LLM to help just be a double check. Okay, this last one is pretty important. In the six-step problem solving process that I talk about, the last step is to test your code. I don't want you using an IDE or a debugger a lot in your interview practice. This is one of the things that also is challenging about using something like LeetCode, because for LeetCode, there's a debugger there, but you might not get an actual debugger at all for your real interview. You need to know how to review your code yourself, checking line by line and turning your brain into a compiler. Once you've done that, what you can then do is turn it over to the LLM and ask it how it might improve the code that you've written. And maybe it makes some helpful suggestions that you can use and incorporate into future problems that you work on. Maybe it can help you also understand if there are common kinds of mistakes that you make. Again, nothing beats working with a human being, but being able to have an LLM tool is better than nothing. Using these tools are designed not to replace you, but to supplement the work that you're already doing. You never want to use AI and LLM tools as a crutch. Using interview preparation as an opportunity to get better at using those tools is just going to be a win for you and help you to think more responsibly about how to augment your abilities, not to replace you. And that does it. Those are the five things that I could come up with. There's probably more, but let's hear from you. What do you think I could have added? Is there a way that you're using these tools in a way that I didn't mention? Let me hear from you. I would love to understand how folks are using AI to make this work a little bit easier. All right, y'all, I gotta get up out of here, but peace.